So this is my third year at the Hindu Lit Fest. 2 years ago I came as part of the audience. Last year I was part of two sessions. This year, by accident and not by design, I have been propelled to be in the forefront of the Lit Fest. But I am not very happy to have been in the forefront, because the circumstances are not a very happy circumstances. This Lit Fest has been dominated by the silencing of the great Tamil writer Perumal Murugan. Perumal Murugan is a dear friend of mine, and I am a great admirer of his work. Perumal Murugan is at the height of his creative powers, but certain Hindutva caste organizations, casteist organizations, and economic vested interests have joined hands, and with the abetment of the local administration, have silenced this great writer. It is not yet 5 days since he had to sign a document withdrawing his book. He signed it under duress. He was supposed to come to a panel. I had organized a panel here where he was supposed to speak, but that was not to be. Perumal Murugan declared after signing this agreement that the writer Perumal Murugan is dead. He will not write anymore. He is withdrawing all his books, and he called all his readers to destroy the books that they had bought. It is in these circumstances, the panel that was supposed to have had Perumal Murugan in it was reconstituted as a panel to express solidarity for Perumal Murugan. The audience, my fellow writers, publishers and activists have joined together, and they have expressed their displeasure and unhappiness and the condemnation of what has happened in the strongest terms. And as somebody who knows Perumal Murugan very well, I have had to take the lead in sharing information about his achievements, what is going on. So this literary festival has been dominated by the silencing of Perumal Murugan. That has also come with another cost, apart from the emotional cost. I have had to miss a number of sessions. I would have liked to attend the session on U.R. Anantamurthy. I would have liked to attend a number of other sessions, but I could not attend because I had to talk to a variety of writers, cultural activists and the media to give them inputs on Perumal Murugan. So I think this Lit Fest for me is a memorable one, but not for very pleasant reasons. And I would be failing in my duty as a writer, as a Tamil writer, if I did not thank the organizers of the Hindu Lit Fest and the Hindu newspaper for the stellar manner in which they have supported Perumal Murugan and the larger cause. My salutes to them. I would like to name them Nirmala Lakshmanan, N. Ram, N. Ravi and Malini Parthasarathi. All of them have supported Perumal Murugan in unequivocal terms. Because of their support, I think the issue has taken the national stage, and I fervently hope, despite my cynicism which comes from experience, I fervently hope that things will turn around sooner than later.